There was a sound of revelry by night, and Belgium's capital had gathered then her beauty and her chivalry, and bright the lamp shone o'er fair women and brave men. A thousand hearts beat happily, and when music arose with its voluptuous swells, soft eyes looked love to eyes which spake again, and all went merry as a marriage bell. But hush, hark, a deep sound strikes like a rising knell. Did you not hear it? No, 'twas but the wind, or the car rattling o'er the stony street. On with the dance, let joy be unconfined. No sleep till morn, when youth and pleasure meet to chase the glowing hours with flying feet. But hark, that heavy sound breaks in once more, as if the clouds its echo would repeat. And nearer, clearer, deadlier than before. Arm. Arm! It is. It is the cannon's opening roar. Within a windowed niche of that high hall sat Brunswick's fated chieftain. He did hear that sound the first amidst the festival, and caught its tone with death's prophetic ear. And when they smiled because he deemed it near, his heart more truly knew that peal too well which stretched his father on a bloody bier and roused the vengeance blood alone could quell. He rushed into the field and, foremost fighting, fell. Ah, then and there was hurrying to and fro, tears and tremblings of distress, and cheeks all pale which but an hour ago blushed at the praise of their own loveliness. And there were sudden partings such as press the life from out young hearts, and choking sighs which ne'er might be repeated. Who could guess if evermore should meet those mutual eyes, since upon night so sweet such awful morn could rise? And there was mounting in hot haste. The steed, the mustering squadron, and the clattering car went pouring forward with impetuous speed, and swiftly forming in the ranks of war. And the deep thunder, peal on peal, afar and near, the beat of the alarming drum roused up the soldier ere the morning star, while thronged the citizens with terror dumb. The foe, they come, and wild and high the Camerons gathering rose, the war note of Lochiel, which Albin's hills have heard, and heard too have her Saxon foes. How in the noon of night that pibroch thrills savage and shrill. But with the breath which fills their mountain pipes, so fill the mountaineers with a fierce native daring which instills the stirring memory of a thousand years. And Evans, Donald's fame rings in each clansman's ears. And Arden waves above them her green leaves, dewy with nature's teardrops as they pass, grieving, if aught inanimate e'er grieves, over the unreturning brave. Alas, ere evening to be trodden like the grass, which now beneath them but above shall grow in its next verdure, when this fiery mass of living valor, rolling on the foe and burning with high hope, shall molder, cold and low. Last noon beheld them full of lusty life. Last eve in beauty's circle proudly gay. The midnight brought the signal sound of strife. The morn, the marshalling in arms. The day, battle's magnificently stern array. The thunder clouds close o'er it, which when rent, the earth is covered thick with other clay, which her own clay shall cover, heaped and pent, rider and horse, friend, foe, in one red burial blent.